Hello everyone, we are back with the new session for the subject serving 2 of the unit photogrammetry. So this is our session number 2. So previously in the photogrammetry chapter we have seen that what was photogrammetry, what do you mean by a photogrammetry concept, what are its types, what are its functions, how they are being taken, what do you mean by vertical photograph, what do you mean by oblique photograph, and so on. So moving to the next part. So next point is the flight planning. So what do you mean by flight planning? So it is related with the vertical photograph. Okay, so as the name indicates, flight. So in the case of the vertical photographs, when they are to be used for the preparation of the maps, all the methods of compilation require that the plumb points of the preceding and succeeding prints are visible in each photograph. Okay, and the photographs are taken at the proper interval along each strip to give the desired overlap of photographs in the given strip. So in that case, two types of overlaps have been taken into consideration, which are nothing but longitudinal overlap, which is also called as forward overlap or simply overlap, and second one is the side overlap. So what is the purpose of taking these overlaps? So basically, whenever the area is to be surveyed by aerial photogrammetry, the photographs which are being taken should be taken in such a manner that when you are going to do the interpretation of that, they should be easy to interpret. Okay, so the photographs which are being taken in the direction of the flight line, that are called as longitudinal overlap, and the photographs which are taken, okay, just they are parallel but they are having an overlap over the first flight, that are nothing but your side overlap. In the case of the longitudinal overlap, they have been restricted up to 55% to 65% only. Okay, so this has been decided as per the norms. So along a given flight, photographs are taken at such a frequency as to cause successive photographs to overlap each other by 55% to 65%. Okay, so it is shown in the figure A. Okay, so suppose this is my flight A, where from where the aircraft is traveling, and as I move in the forward direction, that is my aerial vehicle, that is my aircraft. So first photograph was been taken at this position. Okay, second photograph, when it was taken when the aircraft was here, you can see that the second photograph is having an overlap of almost 50% to 60% of the previous, which is shown by the dotted line. Okay, so again, that is this dotted line. When the aircraft is moving to the third position in order to take the third photograph, you can check it out, it is also having an overlap of 50% to 60% of that of the second photograph. So likewise, the aircraft moves in the forward direction and goes on taking the photographs with having a longitudinal overlap. So basically, this figure shows an area which is to be surveyed. So when the aircraft will travel in this direction, again traveling at a far distance, it will take a turn and will come back and again go on taking the longitudinal overlap. So from in this first direction, it was longitudinal overlap only, but you can see that when here the aircraft is traveling in the forward direction, it is taking longitudinal overlap also, okay, one over another, and it is also having a capture over or the lap over the previous flight, that is nothing but your side lap. So in this way, the flight planning has been decided. Okay, so you can see this is nothing but overlap in the direction of the flights, which is nothing but your longitudinal overlap. Okay, so you can see that maximum how much is the overlap portion of each and every photograph. So figure A shows the three successive flight lines, as I told you before, and figure shows the vertical section containing the flight line and showing the overlap. So it is overlap almost more than 50%. Okay, so first photograph was taken up to this point, but when it was taken for the second, it is having a portion of first part as almost 50%, more than 50%. And successively, when the photographs alternately are taken, that are having a overlap of 10 to 30% only. Then, this figure shows the cut section or the side lap between the flight lines. So, that are nothing but the overlap between adjacent flights is known as the lateral overlap or side lap. As I told you that it has been restricted up to 15 to 35% only. So this figure shows the vertical section taken normal to the three flight lines of the figure A. So it is nothing but your side lap. So there are various reasons for overlap. That is nothing but to tie the different pins together accurately. Then in order to reduce the distortions caused by the lens and by the tilt. If the overlap is more than 50%, these distortions and the displacements can be overcome quite effectively while constructing the maps. Also, in order to view the pairs of photographs stereoscopically, only the overlap portion is useful. So at least the portion of overlap should be a 50%. Again, if the flight lines are not been maintained straight and parallel, the gaps between the adjacent strips will be left, and these gaps can be avoided by having side lap. So for this purpose, you are requiring the corresponding longitudinal overlap and side lap. Okay. So moving to the next point, ground control for photogrammetry. So now in the case of the ground control for photogrammetry means what? In this case, you are supposed to define the certain benchmarks from where the photographs are supposed to be started, where it is to be stopped, or from where the aircraft has supposed to take the turn or change its direction of the flight. Okay, so that are nothing but your ground control for photogrammetry. So we'll see that. So as I told you that it consists in locating the ground position of the points which can be identified on aerial photographs. Okay, next. So it is essential for establishing the position and orientation of each photograph in space relative to the ground, and the extent of the ground is required is determined by its scale. Okay, then second, the navigational control, that is the pilot who is controlling the aircraft, and third one, cartographical process by which the maps will be produced. So basically this ground survey for establishing the control is divided into two parts. First is the basic control and second one is the photo control. So basic control is over the ground only. Okay, so that is nothing but in order to establish the triangulation stations, traverse stations, azimuth marks, benchmarks, etc. And second, photo controls are nothing but which are related to the photographs which are been taken from the aerial cameras, and they are been basically related with the basic control. So each of these controls introduces horizontal control as well as vertical control, which are known as basic horizontal control, basic vertical control, horizontal photo control and vertical photo control respectively. So now moving to the next part, we will see what is the importance application of photogrammetry. So as any of the part is having certain importance, it has also, that is advantage it is having, also there are certain disadvantages of any point or any theory. Okay, so first of all we will see what is the advantage. So if you want to cover the large area, this photogrammetry is useful. Second, it is less time consuming, that is it is a fast process by which you can conduct the survey. Next, it can reach the inaccessible area and restricted area. Suppose there is a presence of a deep valley or correspondingly hilly areas there in which practically survey cannot be conducted by regular instruments. In that case, you can go for this photogrammetry. So it is cheap or less cost effective for large area. That is, suppose if you are interested in measuring the area of entire area, okay, of which it is more than 100 square kilometers or 500 square kilometers, thousands of square kilometers, in that case it is a lesser effective, that is it is cheap in cost. And in the long run, as the photographs will be in soft copy, you can interpret anytime and understand it. Okay, so as it is having advantage, it is also having disadvantage. So it is a complex system, highly trained human resources are needed. So as I told you that in the case of photogrammetry, you are requiring a trained person. Okay, so it is not just like pressing some buttons and controlling the photographs. So for that purpose you are requiring a trained person. So cost is more at the time of installation or for the initiation of the photogrammetry. The initial cost is more. Heavy and sophisticated equipments are needed, that is the cameras which are to be installed over the aircraft, that are heavy and are very costly also. And in also to conduct such kind of photogrammetric survey, the administrative procedure is much lengthy in order to get the permission to fly the aircraft. And most difficult task is that it is weather dependent. So whenever there is a weather fault is there in that case, or it is a rainy period, in that case you cannot go for, or in the presence of the fog, this photogrammetric survey cannot be conducted. So these are the various advantages and disadvantages of the photogrammetry. Moving to the next part, that is stereoscope. So it is an instrument used for viewing stereo pairs. Okay, so basically this stereoscope is being designed in order to see the photos which are being taken from the aircraft, that can be seen in 3D view. Okay, so they are designed for two purposes. First is to assist in presenting to the eyes the images of a pair of photographs, so that the relationship between convergence and accommodation is the same as would be in natural vision. And second one is to magnify the perception of the depth. So basic purpose is whatever is the photo that has been taken from the aerial cameras, it should be same as that what would be seen by the natural vision, that when the person was traveling over the surface of the earth. Okay, so basically there are two types of the stereoscopes. First one is the mirror stereoscope and second one is the lens stereoscope. Most of the time the theory is only asked on mirror stereoscope in the paper, so we'll have a more detailed discussion over the mirror stereoscope only. Okay, so as I told you, there are two types, mirror stereoscope and lens stereoscope. So mirror stereoscope, so you can see there are two images here, or photos or figures. First one is the stereo pair of nail and second one is the mirror stereoscope. So in the figure A, the mirror stereoscope is shown in the figure B. Okay, and in the case first, you can see a nail is been just mounted over a wooden plank, okay, and or on a block of timber, and is being photographed by two camera positions. Okay, so these are nothing but the two positions, that is nothing but your L and L dash, that have been photographed, where A is the topmost position, head of the nail, and B is the bottom, that is tail of the nail. So these two negatives are taken from that. So as I told you, that the mirror stereoscope is shown diagrammatically in the following figure B, and the mirrors M and M dash are there, okay, this small, and which are oriented at an angle of 45 degree. So I'll tell the what is the principle behind this. So basically, in order to see the photo in the 3D image, you are supposed to see the principle this. So first of all, a nail is been mounted over the block of a timber and is being photographed by two camera positions, as I told you. So in this case, the camera lens is placed first in the position of the left eye, okay, and second in then in the right eye, and separate photographs are taken in each position. Okay, so first of all, the photo is taken from left side and again from the right position. So it can be seen that the head of the nail is to the left in the left film. Okay, so you can see here that head of the film A in the negative, it is on the left side, whereas on the negative second, it is on the right in the right film. So these negatives which are been taken, okay, that is photographs which are been taken, that are to be used in order to see that particular image, that is nothing but AB in the 3D with the help of mirror stereoscope. So this contact prints from these negatives are placed in the mirror stereoscope. Okay, so as here it is shown that AB first negative is placed in this direction and second it is placed here, that is the print of this negative 1 and negative 2. Okay, so only where only images of the nail are drawn. Second, then in this case the mirror telescope, 4 mirrors are there, okay, which are been placed in order to transfer the light to the eyes exactly as if it had come from nail as shown by the dotted line. Okay, so this is the 3D image which we are going to see after exactly overlapping this both these images from the retina. These positions are nothing but our eye positions. Okay, so in this case the total distance BM, capital M, small m and capital E, and that of this B dash, capital M dash, small m dash and capital E dash from the eye to the plane of the photographs varies from 30 cm to 45 cm. Okay, so in order to that the unaided eye may comfortably view the photographs. Again, this deflection angle phi is determined by the separation of the photographs that gives the most eye comfort. That is, whenever it is seen that when there is fault in the, some of the persons are having specs, so the deflection angle varies. So the percentage of overlap which is to be determined, that is, which is varying between 50 to 60% in the case of longitudinal overlap, and 10 to 30% that of the side overlap, it varies. Okay, so each magnifier has a focal length slightly smaller than the distance B. This distance, it varies with respect to the type of stereoscope, that is the distance B, M, M, E, which I told you it was 30 cm to 45 cm. And some of the mirror stereoscopes are having a removable binoculars which are placed at this position E and E dash. So in order to get a clear image, binoculars are provided at the top of that. So this is the actual picture of the mirror stereoscope. Okay, so in which you can see the two photographs are been placed. Okay, that is the print of the negatives which are been taken from the aerial photographs, and two mirrors are been placed here. You can see first mirror is at this position, second here it is, third mirror is at the back side of this, and fourth mirror is placed here. So whatever is the image, so the light effect is been transferred from the photo to this mirror, and from photo from this mirror to this mirror, and directly to the retina, that is B to M, capital M, then capital M to small m, and then capital E. Okay, so that is dash here, here it is B dash, then M dash, capital M dash, that is small m dash, and capital E dash, that is E dash. So here we are going to place our eyes and see the 3D image of this. That is nothing but your principle of mirror stereoscope. Okay, so this was regarding the theory part, and in the next part we will see the photo problems based on the photograms. Okay, so we stop here. If you are having any query, you can leave a comment below this.